and the devil's grin. She kinda stared me down as I looked her up. She said, I'm your poison, now you drink a cup. In the heat of the night is when she comes alive. She gonna push, push, cause she's satisfied. I want your eyes real fast on the red hot lips. She whispers, if you wanna taste my love, why don't you swallow this? Uh-huh.
Love on the rocks. Love.
Love on the rocks. She's my shot.
I'll raise a toast to all of us who are breaking our backs every day. If only a good life is such a crime, Lord, then pull me away. Yeah, it's to ya. We'll be right back.
love. Well, my daddy thinks I'm going crazy, and my poor boss wears on losing my cool. But I just want to play with my baby.
I'm coming home now. I need to- Silently still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we feel miles apart inside. Was it something I said or something I did? Did my words not come out right? Though I tried not to hurt you, though I tried. But I guess that's why they say every rose has its thorn. Just like every night has its dawn. Just like every cowboy sings a sad, sad song. Every
rose has its thorn.
Yeah, it does.
I listen to a favorite song playing on the radio, where the DJ said it was a game of easy come and easy go. But I wonder, does he know? Has he ever been like this? And I know that you would be here right now if I could have let you know somehow. I guess every rose has its thorn, just like every night has its dawn, just like every cowboy sings a sad, sad song. Every rose has its thorn. Though it's been a while now, I can still feel so much pain, like the knife that cuts you, the wound heals, but the sky, that sky
say. Instead of making love, we both made a several ways. And now I here found somebody new, and that I never meant that much to you. To hear that tears me up inside, and to see you cuts me like a knife. I guess every rose has its thorn, just like every night has its dawn, just like every cowboy sings a sad, sad song. Every rose has its thorn.
Come with me.
fights at the local police.
And it's all because your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll.
Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll.
But when evening rolls around and it's time to hit the town, where do you go? I'm blaming a little CP.
Yeah. play. Magazine covers all the shooting ball in his face. He kept the score of his ladies chopped up on his guitar case. He was a man and rockin' baby, always rolling out the sound. Like some freight train come and did a six string strut and just time to die, blast all the crowd. He was living for the minute, living his life from day to day. If you want it, then take it. He said, well, that's the rules if you wanna play.
Poison.
With this album and the way that it's been turning out, the production team with Tom Warman and Dwayne Barron and John Purdell and Richard and everyone have brought out what I think Poison is. We wrote all the songs in the album except for Mama Don't Dance. And we wrote those songs. At practice, we said, listen, let's find a sound we'd like in the rehearsal hall and try to capture that live sound. Our new album cover, as a matter of fact, is going to make people stare at it. We've got the strangest picture on our album cover, and it's just going to make people say, what is this? Why is this on here? And it's not anything more than just slightly haunting. And it's slightly weird, but yet it's like I said, it's taboo. It's like you're looking at it and say, this is wrong, but this is right. What is it? And I think that's the reaction I got when we were showing the album cover to people. And it just caused that reaction. Like, why? What is this? But at the same time, they kept looking at it, and I thought, that's the reaction I want. When you have something that's too normal or too passe, people, it's easy to swallow. You know, it goes right in, comes right out. You know what I'm saying? With Poison, it's kind of hard to digest. So it sticks with you for a while.
I'll be the first to admit I have the least drive in, as far as the get up and go to meetings and get up and do this. I mean, I'll sit in my studio and write for like 3 days in a row. But, you know, see, everyone has their strong points. You know, everyone says, so the lovely thing about this band, it's a well-oiled puzzle. Songwriting, musicianship, you know, wind guitar, things like that. Bobby's good at selling, promotion, business. I'd have him as F. Lee Bailey in a few years, honestly. Yeah. He just has that mind. Brett knows how to package things. Brett knows what the girls like. Brett knows what kids like. Brett has an adult, and he's able to look through kids' eyes. He's able to see the problems that are going on right now. He's very aware like that. Plus, he's very, very good looking. He's very social, and he just has that very... He's charming. Brett's very charming. But he has that gift to zero in on things. Ricky is just artistic. I mean, he's Van Gogh. Ricky, I think, is actually the Van Gogh's ear that grew.
basically, Poison is my real first band. I've never played live in any other band except for Poison. You know, I played in a couple garage bands, and interestingly enough, Ricky and Brett were in a band, I guess, called Spectres, if I'm correct. And their band split up. And the same day their band split up, I left my band. And just through a mutual friend, you know, looking for a bass player, that same day they called me. We got together, and everything worked out, and it was fine. And we got a different guitar player than CeCe, and we came to LA, and we found CeCe DeVille, and the rest just happened. Well, when we come to LA, it wasn't pretty. I mean, I look back, and I have a lot of great memories, because I think it's a lot of those early days of struggling and starving that really make and form your personality and who and what you are. It's one thing to be, you know, there's nothing wrong with it, but none of us come from rich families. You know, it's one thing to be handed something. Everything Poison has, we work for extremely hard. And I think it shows. I think it shows in how much we care about what we do. You know, we go 110% with everything. All of us are very good musicians. We don't have to defend that whether we're musicians or not. I play what I was influenced by. I grew up on songs. You know, I'm not in this business to show you how many notes per second I can play. All I care about is the heart and soul of the song. That's it. A great song is a great song, and that's all there is to it.
Every rose has its thorn, just like every night has its dawn, just like every cowboy sings a sad song. Every rose has its thorn. It does.
I started to realize it about 6 months ago.
What do you mean, the popularity thing? Yeah.
Well, that's what's weird. I think our lives start. I think your life changes the day you say you want to be a rocker. And you pick up a guitar or drums or something, start playing that kind of stuff. Everyone treats you different. You can't get out of school early to go practice drums for a rock band. No. You can if you're a majorette or something, you know, or in a high school band or something. You can't. You know, you're instantly an outsider. You're a rebel, man, you know?
You know, I go by the newsstand and I see my picture everywhere. But I don't really think that I've made it yet to myself. I don't think that, gee, am I as big as Kiss is? Am I as big as these bands are? When you're inside looking at it, you don't know if you're really that famous yet. I mean, other people say, gee, I know you're from Poison. But when you're traveling in it yourself, I don't really realize, am I that big or not? I mean, I obviously I look at the magazine and I see I'm there, but I don't feel any different.
We were playing an Under 21 show, and it was sold out, and we came on stage and we were just going nuts, you know what I'm saying, explosions, everything, and the people outside the place with banners saying, you know, rock and roll is poisoning the youth of America, you know what I'm saying, and I thought, Poison, that's it, we're the poison, you know, we are poison, we're what you don't want, you know what I'm saying, love it or hate it, it's poison, and we were coming across, and me and Ricky and Bobby and Matt, and we're sitting in the van, and we said, wait a second, what a cool name, Poison, it just sticks.
I think you gotta be extreme. I think everything in rock and roll is extreme. When you do stick, when you do climb up to the highest branch, it could snap. You know what I'm saying? But that's a risk you take. And a lot of people's branches do snap halfway through their career. You know, that's a scary thing. But it's always those people that are daring and brave that want to climb to the top. We're the first people to come to the party and the last guys to leave. We're the obnoxious one that they finally hung around so long trying to kick the keg. The guy, the security finally said, you guys are going to have to get out of here, or whoever was having the party. I know we were those kind of guys because we're still that way.
You know, our problem is, as we grew up, you know, as I grew up, and I think the other guys, as we grew up, we read the magazines, we listened to the interviews, we heard the stories, and we believed them. And now we're stuck being that way. We can't change it because we believed it.
Some people burn their candle at both ends. You've heard that.
Yeah. We take a torch and burn it right in the middle.
Yeah, we do.
Fallen Angel.
It's a song about living experiences, about people, you know, girls especially, moving out to the big city, trying to, you know, getting wrapped up in the big time and getting eaten up by the city of angels, you know, the city of lights. True message that we really have is entertainment. You know, we're there simply to make people have a great time, to dance, to enjoy our music, to put smiles on your faces, to forget about your job, and have a great time.
All the parties and limousines, such a good actress, how you know?